Hello guys, in this video we are going to learn about loops in PHP. So before that we have to know what is a loop. So a loop is basically this programming technique using which you can manage your program to do a same thing repeatedly. Okay, so suppose if you want to print a particular string or a number say 100 times, so you're not going to do it every time. Okay, so what you can do is instead you can create a loop and the loop will do the work instead of you. Okay, so in PHP there are four kinds of loop. The first one is for loop, the second one is while, the third one is do while, and there is one more loop known as for each loop. Okay, so we are going to cover the first three loops in this video and we'll do the for each loop after the array tutorial. Okay, so let's start. So we are back on Sublime Text. Let's create a new file and save it as loop underscore demo dot php. So first of all we are going to see how a while loop works. Okay, so let's start with the PHP syntax, that is this and the closing tags. Now suppose I want to print a name, anybody's name, say 100 times. Okay, so now one of the methods is this, that you write it like this, you print echo and you do it all over again for 100 times. But as you can see, it's not a very efficient method. Okay, so if you are able to print out 1000 times or maybe 10,000 times, but what if you have to print out something say 1 lakh times? Okay, so that would be very very inefficient to code. So instead what we are going to do is we are going to use a while loop to print a name 100 times. Okay, so for that what we are doing is we are taking a variable known as called as counter, and we are initiating the value to be say 1. Okay, so we have initiated the counter's value to be 1, and now what we are doing is this is how we write a while loop. We write the while keyword, we put a bracket, and inside over here we are writing while counter is not equal to, or while counter is less than equal to 100. And over here I'm putting the brackets and I'll write the code here, whatever I want to do multiple times. Okay, so now let's go back to the syntax. While is the keyword, inside over here you provide the condition till the loop has to be true. Okay, so now if the loop is true, if the condition is true, the programming, the interpreter will go inside over here and it will execute the code written over here, which is echo Rahul. Okay, and now since you want to increment the counter every time, you will just do counter plus plus like this. Okay, so now if you go back, for the first time the value of counter is 1, so the interpreter comes here and it says okay, dollar counter is 1, so 1 is less than equal to 100, which is true, basically 1. Okay, so if it's 1, it will go over here, it will print out Rahul and it will increase the value of the counter by 1. Now the counter value is 2. Okay, so now again the counter will come over here and it will be written as 2 is less than equal to 100, which is again 1, basically true. So again it will come down and it will print Rahul, and again it will increment the counter value by 1. Okay, so this is how a loop works. What we can do is we can also add a BR statement over here so that we get a line change. Okay, now let's file, save it. Let's go to the browser and let's type the file name. Project folder is PHP demo and the file name is loop underscore demo. Now as you can see, it's Rahul written over here for 100 times. Okay, so this is how a while loop works. Okay, what we can also do is we can also concatenate the value of counter so that you can see how many times the word Rahul has been printed. Okay, let's save it, cancel, reload, and now as you can see, when you go down you see Rahul to be printed over here 100 times. Okay, now that you are done with while loops, let's go and create a similar sort of application using do while loops. Okay, so do while loops are a bit different in their syntax. Actually, do while loops look like this: do while the condition. So basically in while you first check and then you execute, but in do while loops you execute first and then you check the condition for the second time. So in a way, the first time the condition will be always true. Okay, so let's do the same thing. Let's print out Rahul with a BR and let's print out, let's once add counter. We are concatenating the counter variable. Okay, let's save it. Okay, it shows there is some error on line number 9. Okay, so let's go back. I'm sorry. What you have to do is, first of all, you have to insert a condition over here, that is the counter variable should not be greater than 100, and you have to put a semicolon over the condition. Okay, so this is how you terminate a while loop. Okay, so this is the syntax: do, the keyword do, the things that are to be executed, and then the condition in a while loop. Okay, let's save it. Let's go back and reload. Okay, so now as you can see, again Rahul has been printed for 100 times. Great. So now that you know how to use a while loop or a do while loop, what is a typical use case? Why would you use loops in programming? I can give you a simple use case. Suppose you have a database, you are working as a web developer in a e-commerce company, say Amazon or Flipkart, and now your task is to print or display all the elements, all the products that your company sells onto a web page. Okay, now the list of that product, those products will come from the database, right? So you're not going to display every product one by one by writing HTML. What you will do is you will create a common HTML, and then using PHP you will dynamically fetch those database elements and you will print them in a loop. So this is one common example where you print, or you rather use loops in your PHP programming. One more example could be, suppose you are making a social networking website and you want to display the name of the friends of the current user. Again, the user must have more than 10, 50, 100 friends. Okay, so now you're not going to create individual HTML elements for each of the friends. Rather, what you will do is you'll create a common container which will hold the name and the profile pics of your friends, and you will just fetch out all the database elements and you will iterate through them using a loop and print them out on a web page. So that's why you will use a loop. Okay, so now that we are done with do while and while, let's do one more kind of loop, that is for loop. And this is one of the most common loops being used not only in PHP but in other languages too. Okay, so this time what we are doing is, we're not printing out a name 100 times because that is kind of boring. What we will do is we'll print out a table. Okay, tables as in table of 2 or table of 3 or table of 4 kind of thing. Okay, so suppose the number, the table of which we have to print is 12, just an example. Now we want to print the table of 12, so what we will do is we will write for dollar I is equal to 0, dollar I less than 10, or rather dollar I can be starting from 1 because 12 zeros, 12 multiplication by 0 will be 0. So this can be equal to this and dollar I plus plus. Now you must be wondering, you haven't declared this variable. So again, if I forgot to tell you this, in PHP you don't have to declare the variables before you use them. Instead, what you can do is you can dynamically create them and use them like this. Okay, so we have done that. Now as you can see the syntax, in the first part we have initiated the variable I with a value of 1. The second one is the condition where we are checking that the value of I is less than equal to 10. If it's true, it will enter over here to print or execute the statement. Okay, if it's true, it will go here, otherwise it will come out of the loop over here. Okay, and finally we are incrementing the counter, that is by plus plus 1. Okay, now over here what we are doing is we are simply printing out echo dollar num multiplied by dollar I. Now let's take a simple case. For the first time, dollar I would be 1 and num would be 12. So over here it will be written as 12 multiplied by 1. Okay, once it prints out this particular thing, it will increment the value of I. It will come again into the loop because 2 is less than 10, and now it will replace 1 with 2, and it will print 12 multiplied by 2. Similarly, 3, 4, and 5, up until the value is 10. Okay, so now let's replace it. $num multiplied by $i. We can also add a br for line change, save, reload. And now as you can see, 12, 24, 36, 48, 60, up to 120. So you have printed out the table. Okay, but it doesn't look like a well-defined, well-formatted table. So what we will do is, we'll create a well-formatted table using concatenation. So if you remember, the format is like this. 12 multiplied by 1 is equal to 12. So we are going to do it like this. So first of all, you have to print out the number, which is $num. Then you have to print out a string like this. It doesn't change, that's why we are using a string. The next is the current iteration, that is I. And the next is equal to. And finally, the number that you have to print. Okay, so first we printed out the num, then this thing over here, then this thing over here, then this over here, and finally this over here. Okay, now if you save it and if you reload, this is how our table would look, right? And if you change just the value, say if you want to print the table of 67, save it, reload, now it's the table of 67. Okay, so this was a basic demo of for loop.